Hello and welcome to New Junction. You join me this week on another episode of Under Closer Inspection, and I've got to be honest, I'm really excited about this one. I have a lovely box which has arrived today, and this is from GraffRail. Now, this is a customised commission that I've ordered with them, and I've been waiting a number of weeks for this, so I'm really excited to bring you this one. Definitely one to watch. So this all started probably 2 months ago now, when I got in touch with GraffRail. Now, I have seen their advertisements on Facebook and eBay, etc. And I thought I'd send them a message because I wanted a custom item for my new pilot sidings. Now, they were very obliging. Normally, you'd sort of buy one of their pre-weathered wagons or coaches, etc. And I asked if I could buy one slightly customised. So hopefully that's in this box. Now, I had spoken to Alex from GraffRail, and he was very helpful. He listened to all my requests, the endless list, and hopefully he's achieved what I've asked for and sent it to me in this box. So let's get it open. I'm desperate to get it open. It was painful not opening the box as soon as it arrived, but I thought I want to share the excitement with you. Now, Alex did say to me, he has sent me a few extra bits. So I'm eager to see what's in the box. All the wrapping, let's just get rid of that. Ooh. All the wrapping. So what have we got first? British Rail Corporate Identity Manuals, limited edition fine art prints by GraffRail. Very nice little postcards there. Definitely have to get one of them up on the New Junction wall, so I'll put that to one side. This is a laser cut modern image billboard. I presume there's two here, so they come with eight images in each one, I believe. So we'll get these open momentarily, and I'll show you a bit more in depth. Now, the actual item I've ordered is the long item here, the long piece of rolling stock in the Batman box, as we can tell. I'll get that open momentarily. To this one, which is a Dapple wagon box. I didn't order this, so this is quite a surprise. Oh, the tees, look at that. It's got a GraffRail card in the window, so you can't quite see it. What I'm going to do, I think, is dig my light box out in a second, because I've got a feeling this wagon, I presume it's a wagon, yeah, it's a hopper, is going to be graffed up, shall we say. And this is my commission. Oh, look at that, the tees. It's wrapped up in some black wrapping paper there, some tissue paper. Oh, so we really are going to have to dig out the the light box, and I'll show you that a bit close up. Oh, this is exciting. Right, so the light box has been dug out rather quickly, as you'd imagine. So firstly, out of the box were these corporate identity manual postcards. As you can see here, it's one, and I've got three of those. And on one side is the message you can see there. I presume this is more of an advert for the prints that are available on GraffRail's website. And then of course the other side is a nice Mark II coach. So they're quite nice. I need to do a bit more exploring into what they do with those, but the quality of these is quite nice. So I'll move these to one side and we'll get on with what was next in the box. So next out of the box was something that they've sent me off their own back. These were the two packs of modern image billboards. Now here's one pack, which is still in its wrapping. The next one I have opened, I'm yet to build it though, but it is a laser cut kit, as you can see here. So a bit more sturdy than some of the card kits that are otherwise available. I presume you just stick those together and then you get your general instructions for them. And I believe you get 8 different posters to put on them, modern image. So this is, I believe, pack 2 or pack 1. And as you can see, you've got a KFC advert, a film, British Airways on this next one, if I can separate them. A nicely timed Brexit poster. And then more films and a Greggs advert. So very nicely done there. I think what will be best is if I put one together in another episode and see how they look. But I believe I have seen these before on their eBay page, and the billboards themselves are £8 for a kit. So not too bad really, and a nice bit of detail for any layout. But let's move on to what we're really here for, the other boxes. So as you can see, the hopper box, this is how it arrived. They've put a lovely business card in front of the window, so I can't actually see what's in it. So I'm just going to quickly take this out of its box and open it live for you. As you can see, that's how it came. So if I pop this, you've got the GraffRail business card with all their details. Oh, and I really like that. The very Banksy-esque looking British Rail sign. Love it. So, what delights await? We already know it's a hopper. A couple of things they do is, one of the big things is they weather things. So I'd imagine this is going to be a nicely weathered up hopper, which it is. As you can see, very nicely done that. Pre-filled with a coal load. A good example of what they do, really. Hopefully you can see that. All the things I show you today, I will take some photos of, and as ever, stick them on the New Junction Facebook page, which sometimes can hopefully show you a bit more, in a bit more detail than what you can see on the videos. But now I'm really chuffed for that. But I didn't ask for that, and that's something they've thrown in for me. So big thanks to the guys for that one. But now on to the reason we're all here, and I'll tell you, I'm absolutely stoked for this. So as you can see, they've covered this over in black tissue paper. They obviously know it's going to be a big reveal. So it's time to get it out of its outer boxing and dig out the goodies. Right, so that's out of the outer sheath. I'm just building this up now for suspense. It did have another one of their really cool looking cards. I really like those. And here goes for the fun bit. Now obviously I've seen photos of the work. I've not seen it in the flesh yet. And also I know what I originally requested when I ordered this commission. So this is actually genuinely really exciting, because I've no idea what's going to be behind this and what it actually looks like. Ooh, shall we do it? I think we should. Let's see what I've got. So if I go for the sellotape side first. I daren't just rip it off, should I just rip it off? You're probably all screaming at me now to get on with it. I'll do it, I'll commit. And here we are. That was rather exciting. As you can see, it's an Express Parcels Gov van. And it's been really weathered up. So what I'm going to do is zoom you in quickly, just for a quick look at all the weathered details. So now we're zoomed in a bit closer. You can see all the various textures and things that they've put on. If we start from left to right, you can see where the paint has been faded away. You've got rust patches showing through that. Obviously, it's weathered. It's a very abandoned vehicle, which is what I requested, and also what GraffRail are famous for doing. Some of their stuff is just incredible when you see the photos of it. If I tilt you over, you can see the roof as well has had the same treatment. It's varied in its levels of detail. There's so many layers of different types. So in the middle here, you can see where the top paint has been worn off to show an undercoat of, well, rusting steel really, along with all the weathering marks. Bring you over a bit further. Again, you get a bit more of the worn naked steel on the side of the vehicle. And it just really does look the business. However, this isn't what I asked for. What I asked for is on the other side of this coach. So what I'm going to do is recenter it. You can just about see it through one of the windows there, but I'm going to turn it round for you. Right, so without any further ado, here we go. So as you can see, hopefully some of you all have got it. The clue is in the name, GraffRail or Graffiti Rail. I did originally ask the guys, particularly Alex, to see if he could commission me a very unique piece for my layout. And as you can see, hopefully I've achieved that through their skill set. I can't tell you, I'm absolutely thrilled to bits with this. This is 110% what I wanted. Absolutely amazing. The sort of remit I gave him is I wanted it to be custom to me, preferably with the name of the layout on it. So some youths from the local town have been down to the sidings and just graffitied at one of these abandoned coaches. But he's also added a few details subtly. So obviously you've got the new Junction graffiti. But what I'm going to do is take you in for a closer look to see some of the finer details. So of course you've got the same weathering as you had on the other side. So the unit is very nicely done. You can see he's actually put my initials here in smaller text, RW. And then of course, moving a bit further on, you've got only on YouTube. So I think we can quite easily agree with that he has completely ticked off my remit. He hasn't filled it too much with graffiti, because obviously too much I think would spoil it, but I think this is absolutely fantastic. And I can't thank them enough, because this is, as I say, exactly what I wanted, and I think it's going to finish off the scene quite nicely. So without further ado, I'm going to get it out of the light box and I'll put it on the siding. And there we are. That's now nicely on my pilot sidings. What I've also just noticed is he's done the graffiti in red, which of course matches the New Junction LNER East Coast Mainline theme. Which is very nice. As you can see, it matches the HST going past. And I think you'll agree, that's going to look the business on the layout, and I'm really chuffed to bits with it. And there we go. I think you'll agree that looks more than at home on the sidings. I just want to thank Alex, particularly at GraffRail, for putting up with my demands. I should say now, I did pay for this coach, There will be links in the description below if you're interested in getting in touch with them yourselves for a project, or maybe just to check out the various projects they've got ongoing. They do have an eBay store. None of the links below will be an affiliate link at all, so don't you worry about that. They did send me the billboards and the hopper, which is extremely kind of them, and I'll put them to good use on the layout, and I'll show you more of those when they're built. I might even stick them to the arches behind. But as you can probably tell, I'm chuffed to bits with this, and I think it just absolutely makes the scene. I'm going to add a bit more shrubbery around it, I think, as you can see it now, just to make it look a tiny bit more abandoned. But that's absolutely fantastic, and I would highly recommend these guys. Very professional the whole way out. And yeah, like I said earlier, I will put some HD photos on Facebook, just so you can have a better look at this in situ and in the lightbox, and of the hopper as well. But, as ever, guys, thank you very much for watching. I'm now getting on with some big projects on the layout, dare I say at the canopy. Tune in next time. Thank you very much for watching. Take care, guys. Bye. We'll be right back.